When I created the CSV files to move the employee data over to the MySQL tables, I lost all my photo information. Now I want to add those pictures back in. So I downloaded the photos from the website. I've got the two here, the full size and the 300 pixel size. To add them into the database, I will start by clicking on the MySQL Workbench. I will open up the local instance, MySQL 56. Type in the password. Now I want to go into MySQL search form, tables. I'm coming down to the employee table and I'm going to click the wrench. This shows us our column names and the data types. Down under employee pick, we have this set as medium blob. When we set this up, we didn't really talk about what a blob is, so we're going to look at that now. Clicking on the data type, we see there are different kinds. We've got a blob, we've got a long blob, a medium blob, and a tiny blob. I went over to the MySQL website and looked for the max size for each blob. And we see that the tiny blob can hold objects up to 255 bytes. The blob up to 63 kilobytes, the medium blob up to 16 megabytes, and the long blob up to 4 gigabytes. To make our database tables most efficient, we want to try and keep the table size as small as possible. So we should use the smallest possible blob that will work for our situation. Here are the pictures at the 300 pixel level, and our largest blob is 17 kilobytes. At 17 kilobytes, a blob would be plenty of room because it's got 63, more than enough room for any picture in this file. And I have these sorted by size with the largest at the top. If I'm using the full size pictures, again, I've sorted it largest at the top. It's 1,200 kilobytes. So for that one, we're going to need to use the medium blob at 16 megabytes. I am going to use the 300 pixel pictures, so a blob should be plenty of space. Let's update this to blob. Then I need to apply. We have the SQL created. Now let's apply the SQL, and the update is done. Now I'm coming back over to the employee table, and I'm going to click on the table icon. I'm scrolling over to the right and I see the employee pick. It's a blob. If I right click on this, we have something called open value in editor. I'll click that. We see there's nothing in the binary, nothing in the text. Oh, in clicking that, you may see MySQL Workbench crash. But in this case, we didn't. So I'm going to load in a photo. We will put in Michael Williams, open. We see something in the binary now, something in the text, but we don't see the picture. Let's apply it, close, and then reopen. Now we've got another tab that says image, and there's our picture. We can close this. Since we know that all the rest of these don't have anything in it, I'm going to click on the second one, hold down shift and click on the bottom. Now I'm going to right click and set the fields to null. Now we've made our change, but it's only in this area. We haven't applied it to the database. We still need to click apply here for it to create all the SQL. Now I click apply. And our updates are made to the table. I'm going to close MySQL Workbench and open up a new database in LibreOffice. I want to connect to an existing database, a MySQL database. Next, I want to connect to a JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. Next. The database name will be MySQL Search Form. And the server is localhost. Let's test the class. That is good. Next. Let's put in the username of root. Password required. Test that connection. I gotta type in the password. And that one is good. Now we'll register this and open the database for editing. Finish. I will call this database pictures ODB and click save. Now I'm going to create a form, and I'll use the wizard to create the form. I'm going to choose my table as the employee table. I will add in the last name, first name. We'll put in the address. We'll put in the hourly wage and the employee pick. Next, we don't need a subform. Arranging the controls. It's set up as a spreadsheet. I'm going to choose columnar labels on top. I'm going to leave this as the default. Apply the styles. Let's change this to ice blue. That sounds good. Next. And I'm going to give this form the name of pictures. And we'll modify the form. Going to select the employee pick, move it over a little bit, hold down control, click on the picture area, and arrange it more like a portrait picture. Now let's see how this looks. I'm going into design mode, and there's the picture that we added from the MySQL workbench. Going to the next one, I want to add in another picture for David Brown, so I'm going to right-click. I see insert picture from, and here we have all the pictures. I'll select David Brown, and there he's added in. We can save this, go on to the next, add them in for the rest of the employees. And that's how we add pictures into a LibreOffice database using MySQL.